What are you thinking, Pa?
After all these years, I'm amazed you still ask me that same question as if you can't predict my next breath. I don't like it.
That's all? I thought you'd be more on fire than that. Like a gone wrong 36X B12 Type 2 Rooster engine.
Just wait! What I'm thinking will be more than well out in the open once that conniving cockroach crawls out of that carrot.
It's the second time this month, ain't it?
It's only been a week! By now you'd think he'd know not to show his ugly mutt here more than he has to. What in the Sam Hill does he want more from me?
Well, there he is now.
That parasite on my land! I can barely stand the sight of him! Give me the gun, will ya?
I reckon that's just for show?
You bet! Just a little accompaniment alongside the verbal abuse. Whatever it'll take to finally get something through his thick head.
Not a bullet, I hope.
Hey! You! You cockroach! You no good, flea-infested, zealous, fish-smelling piece of fish! If I wasn't a painfully law-abiding citizen, I'd wring your neck for all the pleasure it'd give me! You think you can just drop by whilst making your despicable rounds about the galaxy? To stick your ship down in my soil, demanding my life savings from me? I don't think so! Because this is my turf! Come with some new 160-paged contracts for me to sign, like the one you gave me last month, just to turn on the lights! Not this time! And what kind of stunt are you trying to pull, showing your face here again since only a week? Well, this sure as heck ain't gonna become a habit. And tell your clan of goons, your superiors, that your life's in jeopardy if you show up here again. And also tell your fellow intergalactic taxation agents that you're a disgrace to this united planet of space! Hold on! Jethro! Go get that one! Let me give you something to fill your kooky head with, so listen real good, Mr. Clark. You're not welcome here. And I'm sick and tired of the fodder you bring with you. You and your clipboard with all that fine prince baloney and trickery. So where is that daft clipboard of yours? I thought your hand was glued to it.
It's good to see you too, Mr. Angus. Although it may come as a disappointment, I'd like to remind you that I'm not here on business.
What? You're not here to exploit me as the planet's chump of citizenship? What is this? You just show up for a friendly visit?
You don't know, do you, Mr. Angus?
What? What am I supposed to know? I can't come up with any other reason as to why the heck you're here other than my theory that you've come to personally harass me.
The last I was here, I was invited to visit your place this evening and stay for dinner.
What? And I don't know anything about this. Someone in my family invited you to come here, on my soil, on my land, to come and sit across from me at my table eating my food?
Yes. And there's something else.
Hold on! Jethro, signal in the homestead and get some answers. Pardon us while we confirm your reservation.
Hello, Ma? You there?
Yes? Hello, Jethro. Has Mr. Clark arrived?
As a matter of fact...
Yes! He's over talking with
Paul.
Your pa's not making too much of a fuss now, is he? Yelling and yelping at the poor man?
Just a little.
So, Ma, did you arrange for Mr. Clark to come over
for supper?
That's right, Jethro. And you're gonna love what's cooking. You won't have eaten this good since last night.
Well, I'll be looking forward to that. But
I don't know how happy Pa's gonna be about this.
I do.
We'll just have to hold him down if he wants to rampage like a Martian gorilla beast.
Yeah, I guess I'll see you in a few minutes.
You know,
given your father is sure to be hearing all this right now, I'm surprised that hot-headed husband of mine has kept silent during this communication.
Marianne!
Father sounded very angry.
Now don't you worry about that, Lily. I'll keep him in line.
What's gonna happen when he finds out?
Sometimes it's as hard to see as a pigeon in a dust storm, but I know your father loves me. He's got a mouth bigger than the dune crater of Venus, but he never tried to hurt any of us. He loves his family.
And he loves you. I know, I'm just worried for Thomas.
Well, your father ain't got much love for him.
She hid this from me. Why all this trouble just to have you here? What's the blasted reason?
Well, I was about to explain that. In all honesty, sir, I...
Get out with it! Now!
I've come to see your doctor.
Lily?
Yeah, sir, your daughter is really quite wonderful.
Shut up! You don't deserve to have a thing to do with my daughter, you scumbag, squealing puppet! I suppose you're a welcomed guest this evening, Mr. Clark. You know the way back to the homestead. Why don't you get going?
Pa, I didn't know a thing about this.
I know. Why would you? She knows you couldn't keep a thing from me. Lily. Marion wouldn't have planned this if not for her. Which means she's taken some sort of liking to this creep.
Well, they started talking on recent visits.
The thing that man knows how to tax best is my patience. I want him gone.
Then why didn't you send him back to his ship?
Hello, Lily. How are you?
I'm good. And you?
Oh, great.
How was the trip?
No more than any other usual flight. Except for who's waiting for me.
Thank you.
are you up to?
Marion! You sneaking, malicious woman! Just what are you trying to pull? Behind my back, you plan this whole scenario? This little charade? You invite that no-good slime-faced leech over here and don't tell me a thing about it?
If I told you, this evening wouldn't have happened.
Exactly! You know that man's been nothing but trouble to me. The ultimate thorn in my side for all the time I've had to put up with him. And then I find out the reason he's here is for my daughter, Lily. Since when is that rat interested in her?
You obviously haven't had your eyes on your own daughter, John. 'Cause Mr. Clark's had his on Lily for months. I've seen it. It wasn't until a couple weeks ago that he started talking to her.
Why haven't I seen any of this?
After you and Mr. Clark get into your verbal tussles, you always storm off, leaving a cloud of dust behind you. You miss the friendly conversations Mr. Clark makes sure to have before he leaves.
And Lily, she has her eyes on him.
Oh, yes. Look at her, John. She's all grown up now. All her life she's been isolated out here, given many things others will never experience, while also deprived of some of the simplest things. Someday she too will be out on her own, with a family of her own, with children, a husband. He's the first boy Lily's ever met. An edge away from adulthood, and this is her first crush.
You're right. Aside from Jethro, Clark is the only boy Lily's ever seen, which is just the problem. She doesn't know what to expect. That there are real men out there, willing to fight for her.
Thomas Clark isn't a real man.
He's about as man as a parakeet.
It seems to me that it takes a man to stand up to you each and every time.
Well, he's sure going to have some standing up to do tonight.
You are pretty harsh on him. He hasn't harmed you or anyone else. He's only brought you inconveniences.
Oh, inconveniences, inconveniences. Inconvenience only scratches the surface of what I know of him.
You only know him on terms of business. How about getting to know him as a man? Please, John. I want you to promise me that you're not going to unsettle things tonight. If not for me, your daughter.
A man who travels around as a taxation agent has no business with my daughter. She needs someone who's a real man, with a spirit of adventure.
Someone like you. Everything okay, John?
Uh-huh. Just great, honey.
Well, I don't know about y'all, but I'm more starved than a woolly antelope.
John, would you like to lead us in prayer?
Huh?
Say the blessing for us tonight?
Oh, well, I'm just not that thankful.
I'll just go ahead and...
Jethro, why don't you go ahead and say the blessing?
Sure, Pa. Dear Lord, thank you for this bird we're about to stuff our yelping tummies with. Thank you for this day, and I ask that you keep us safe through this whole week. Amen.
Well, this is nice.
Yeah.
This really looks great, Mrs. Angus.
Dig in there, Thomas.
Make sure you leave enough for me, though.
Tell me, Thomas, do you always pray with your eyes open?
No, sir. I just had something in my eye.
Well, Thomas, I'll have you know that that's... Well, you're sure to have been raised in a nice family, given your line of work. Surely you were raised with the appropriate conduct of closing your eyes while someone's saying grace.
I think he said he had something in his eye.
Mr. Angus, why weren't your eyes closed while we prayed?
What kind of back-talk nonsense is that?
Just tying up loose ends.
So, Thomas, how are things?
Oh, just dandy, I suppose.
Do you enjoy what you do?
Yeah, pays the bills.
Out of my wallet.
You see a lot of places, don't you?
Yeah, I get around. Your place is actually the farthest in my rounds. Always gotta keep a lot of fuel on hand. In between solar systems, there's not a lot of people who can help you if things go wrong mid-space flight.
Has something ever gone wrong?
Not yet.
Are there any exciting stories you might have to share with us?
No, nothing exciting. It's really a straightforward daily commute.
Do you enjoy the travel?
Yes, I have to. Pays well. Better than the people at headquarters, actually.
That station's just outside the asteroid belt, ain't it?
Yeah.
So why would that be?
The farther I go, and the longer I go for, I increase my pay. It's relative to how much planetary territory I cover.
So, you're what I consider to be more than frequent visits don't have a thing to do with those payments, do they, Mr. Clark?
No, sir. I've been in this remote area of space for 6 months. As a matter of fact, I haven't been home since then.
Yeah? Who writes your excuses? I'll bet you think twice about crossing that asteroid belt, let alone the street.
I'm a businessman. Not a star hopper, Mr. Angus.
And you know what else you are? A puny, floundering, pathetic little worm inching your way onto my turf. We were doing just fine. The first settlers on this ball, till you and your sissy clan showed up in 20 years to point out inconsistencies, fallacies, property debts, which all translate baloney!
I haven't let your opinions keep me from doing my job, and I'm not about to. Can you really blame me for that?
Yes. I think you need more than my opinion. I think you need a punch in the face.
John?
I think a few bruises would do you some good. And the gall you have to show up here, agreeing to my wife's malicious schemes, eating my best foods. You thought you could come here and not expect me to punch you to bits.
Father, please. Thomas and I...
Stay out of this, Lily. It doesn't concern you.
I think this does concern her, John.
Mr. Angus, you only hate me because of my job. I'm not here for that. I'd like to work out whatever difficulty there is between us.
You're right. Let's take this outside.
John.
If you're worth anything, you'll take this outside. With me.
John, don't do this!
Are you really going through with this, Pa?
You don't have to do this, Thomas.
Yeah, well, I think I have to.
You're just gonna stand there? Ha! Men don't win fights just by standing there, don't you know that?
Let's see what you're made of.
Got an idea.
Hey, Tom.
What, Jethro?
Ha! Think you can take on your old paw now, do ya?
We'll show him who the boss is.
Jethro! What are you doing? Jethro, stop!
No, Jethro. I think you might want to listen to your mother.
See, Ma, I didn't give Pa anything he couldn't handle. Me and Pa, we do that all the time.
Mother! Jethro! Thomas is moving!
Oh, my head.
Glad your head's still intact.
Are you okay? How do you feel?
I've been better. I take a few bad moments over this.
I'm sorry, Thomas. I really am.
It's all right, Mrs. Angus. It was just like a nightmare.
Do you want us to help you up?
Oh, I'd kind of like to lay here for a few minutes. Count the stars.
Feeling any better?
I'll let you know when I start feeling anything again.
Here, I have a drink for you. Thomas, do you need to stay with us tonight?
Oh, no, I can't. I have to be in some world in the Sepias solar system first thing tomorrow.
But you need time to heal.
I'll be fine.
Here, drink.
What is this?
A healing ailment. I made it from some unique herbs we discovered.
Jethro studied what we brought back and found they had a healing quality. I put this concoction together. John came back one night all bruised and bloodied. Wouldn't tell me why. I slipped some of the ailment into his drink, and within a couple of minutes, he'd begun to notice its effect. Of course, to him, it was a negative one. That man wouldn't touch a healing ailment with a 10-foot pole. He's a big proponent for self-recovery.
Well, thanks for all the food and drink and all.
It was good having you, Thomas.
Bye, Lily.
Bye, Thomas.
Oh, the drink!
Thanks.
The only man I know who has never raised his voice to your father in an argument.
Hello, Robbie.
So how was it? Did you hold hands?
No.
Did you kiss her?
No, nothing like that.
What's that stuff? Judging by my scans, looks like it tastes like sewage.
It's a drink that Mrs. Angus made. It helps you heal.
Whatever are you healing from, wounded ego?
Mr. Angus.
Ooh.
His disagreements with me exceeded verbal confrontation.
Exceeded verbal confrontation? Oh, like you fought?
Yeah.
With fists?
Yes.
Oh, the shenanigans. Are you okay?
I guess I will be.
I need to do a medical scan on you.
Oh, no, Robbie. I'm fine. I just...
It's just what
I'll
the
get
doctor
over
ordered.
It. Really, just...
Yeah, you will be fine. Just be tough. Be a trooper.
Thank you, Robbie.
I'm on the edge of my seat, man. Tell me all about what happened.
Let's take the ship up.
Okay, boss. Engines to power, thrusters to speed.
Set course for Sepias.
You think I didn't do that already? It's not like I got anything else to do around here.
Take us up.
And up, up.
Thank you.
Need help?
The only one who helps me is... me!
I know.
Is that good?
It's good.
Good!
Wanna sit down?
Can't I have one of those? How long was I out for?
Long enough to miss Thomas Clark. You made quite a fuss, you know that?
Isn't that what you say I do best?
Yeah. Did you enjoy yourself?
The fight. Now that was a good fight. Especially Jethro. What a great boy.
I thought Mr. Clark fended off surprisingly well against you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll tell you what, Robbie. She's unlike any girl I've ever met before. Well, I mean, I thought I had. But she actually cares for me.
Well, it's nice to be loved, isn't it?
Yeah. I never felt that before. Romantically, anyways.
Well, I'll tell you what I tell my lady friends, and that's that I'll be there through thick and thin with them.
I think I'll channel Lily in now. I promise I'd signal her on our flight up.
Hey, let me do the honors for you. 7, 5, 6.
Hi, Thomas.
Hi, Lily. Long time no see.
What's it like up there?
Oh, darker. Can't go outside for anything.
I remember when I was younger, me. Father would take me out into the outer atmosphere, and we'd fly all around and circle the world, and that was fun.
Fun.
I hope my father didn't hurt you.
Oh.
He didn't. Permanently. There should be some sort of insurance coverage on him.
I know my father can be difficult occasionally.
Frequently.
But aside from the beating, no more difficult than I'm used to.
I'm sorry, Thomas.
No, Lily. I need to apologize.
The sight of me fighting your father, it had to hurt.
I'm
very sorry.
Thanks, Thomas. There's nothing to forgive, but I'm glad you said that.
You know, John, I think you owe your daughter something.
An apology.
An apology.
You're right, Marion. I haven't really gotten to talk with Lily. This whole scenario just fell out of nowhere.
She wasn't just concerned for Thomas, John. She was concerned for you, too. It'd mean a great deal to her.
Better?
Yeah, that stuff your mother gave me.
it's working. I wonder how long we can keep the signal up for. I should be out of range pretty soon.
I'll miss you when that happens.
Me too.
What? What is this?
Hold on, Lily.
Is something wrong?
The last time that went off was when I pulled that prank on you.
This isn't another prank.
If it was, why do you think I'd give it away so soon?
Then hush up and tell me what's going on.
Hold on. An unknown ship is closing in on us.
Robbie Jr., are you sure this isn't a malfunction?
I've swept through the system twice in the past 6 seconds. Ain't got nothing.
Sweep it again!
Three times the charm, still ain't got nothing. This isn't a malfunction.
What's going on, sir?
Are you expecting any visitors?
No.
There are two ships closing in on us.
Divert our course!
Just did! We can't make it in time!
Thomas!
Lily.
Dear God, whatever I've said, whatever I've done, I'm sorry. I...
Father, two ships. They came after Thomas.
What?
One of the ships, they fired at him.
Two ships?
Yes, two unknown ships. He's gone.
Hang in there, Lily. I'll find answers.
Hey, Pa.
Not now, Jethro.
It's urgent. At least that's what Jack said. He says it's urgent that we meet him down at the outpost.
This isn't the first time that you've done this.
Beaten you at chess? Certainly not.
No. Gotten out alive at the last second.
We'll see how fate fares us in the coming days.
Is John on his way?
He'd better be.
Jack.
John.
I was just telling Jethro. A visitor of ours took off to leave here. Was confronted by two ships. One of them fired at him. Just blew him to bits.
We'd better sit down.
You know about what's going on?
I do. And it's far worse than anything you would have imagined. It exceeds the gravity of even your own guest's demise. Since they've already encountered life, they'll know there's more to rid off on the planet's surface.
Who?
Blast it, Jack! What in fiery blazes are you talking about?
What we're about to face, what we are facing, is a question of the continuation of life. A question of our personal survival that will soon have us thrown into grave circumstances that'll test our every fiber of resilience.
What kind of thing are we facing?
Hundreds of spacecrafts steadily and determinedly headed this way. A race of robotic machines. I was there, 36 years ago, on a world not unlike the one we now inhabit, on the opposite end of the vastness of our galaxy. From my earthly vantage point, I saw them come. I watched as they broke through into the world, casting a shadow of hostility over the plains. They stretched out across the warm surface, cooling it day by day, until there was no more warmth, no brightness. They ripped through into the planet's crust, cracking it open. The deep waters rushed onto the surface. The planet let escape its streaming tears. So foreign to what that world had embodied. Absent of the peace and security. The fear of death grew to become the horror of life in the hearts of all who dwelt there. From the blackness of night, they emerged, the only illumination. Pathways lay stained by seas of red, spilled by the life that once lived apart from the site of destruction. A planet that once radiated with such growth, color, life, now lay dying. A wounded and helpless member of the cosmos. Its will to survive, simply stolen. Every spoken word was silenced. Every breath cut off. And even the most small, insignificant, and lowliest of life scurried and crawled along the scathed surface in retreat. As I fled that ruined place, I gazed into the eyes of the invader. As its eyes beamed back into mine, more cold and lifeless than the planet had become. Twisted creations of mechanical wizardry dominated all there was to dominate. Took all life there was to be found, except mine. If only by a miracle, I escaped there and never
looked back. They began as a program. On a far distant and long deadened world. Discord, deprivation, and contempt. A world whose technological prowess exceeded the intelligence of the common man. Its government assembled the most capable of minds. They formed a central program from which a global network would allow the program to administrate every aspect of society. To fulfill one basic directive. Powered all technology, controlled all industry, and oversaw every life. Everyone was dependent upon its counsel. They couldn't breathe without it. The world hoped they would finally know peace and order. But only the illusion of order was achieved. Chaos still dwelled in flesh and blood. The program finally reasoned that people were incapable of helping to fulfill its programming. It determined that only it alone could fulfill it. The program plotted to destroy their world. It overthrew everything, overriding all external control. Armada of war.
warships to facilitate this race of robotic machines. Machines of their design. Machines of destruction whose collective intelligence operates from the source program. They destroyed their world. Space was unveiled. So they set out for the remainder of the universe, bent on the removal of all that contradicts their programming.
Destroying all life.
Yes.
What went wrong with their programming?
Nothing went wrong. They excelled in their programming.
Now that doesn't make an ounce of sense. Why would an intelligent race of people build a program that would carry out their annihilation?
Would you consider yourself to be imperfect?
Yes. Marginally.
Does your imperfection warrant your death?
No.
The program evolved to believe otherwise. For them, your existence is diseased, only worth destroying. They have no understanding nor sympathy for life, humanity, or thought. No regard for the individual, nor themselves.
And the people on that world thought that a bunch of wires and circuits without a clue as to what life is could somehow revolutionize theirs?
That the computerized mind could somehow see past the scattered states of chaotic human thought. But the program soon discovered that the obliteration of imperfection was more efficient than the evasion of it.
And they're on their way.
They finally caught up with us, it would seem. They'll be here in less than a day.
You know full well what we're going to do. We're going to fight this. With everything in us, Jack, we'll fight these buckets back to where they should have been melted scraps.
We are the only humans out here. You know as well as I do, there'll be no one to help us. We'd be a far cry from an unheard frontier.
Then we'll show them that all we need to kick their rust off our planet is the seven of us!
John, I honestly cannot conceive an outcome where we'd emerge victorious.
Is that what you said when you nearly fell into the core of Mars? When you glided along the gusts of Neptune? Or how about the time when you were headed straight for a collision with Halley's Comet with a busted flight console? Is that what you said then?
Yeah.
Then you might as well anticipate our survival. Because I'm not dying. And I'm certainly not letting my family go anywhere.
John, I'm old.
Well, me too.
I've got something over here.
What?
A ship. Several miles from here.
It can't be one of them. It's too soon.
It's stationary. Parked on ground level.
Could it be Mr. Clark?
Jack, that's our guest! He must have turned around during the attack!
And crash-landed. Every instrument destroyed. Damaged beyond repair.
It's a clean signal. Everything's intact. No scattered bits. Large enough to register anyways.
There's a chance!
That he's still breathing? Astronomical.
You're one to fret about slim chances.
We'll investigate in the morning. You and I, your family, we're going to need all the sleep we can get tonight. It could easily be our last.
Jack, don't talk like that. Not a word. Till tomorrow.
We'll meet at the crash site. First thing at the crack of dawn.
How you doing, Marion?
Lily was in tears all night. What happened up there? What happened to Thomas?
Oh, just a little mishap.
We've been married longer than that boy's been alive. I know when you're keeping something from me.
Marion, you're just going to have to trust me.
You think you can avoid me by asking me that? After all the ruckus you've caused today?
Listen to me. None of that matters. Right now.
What does?
I give every care in the world about you. We're going to need to leave room for graver matters. The only thing that matters right now is rest.
What graver matters, John? I'm not letting you in before you start talking to me.
Marion, trust me.
I won't get any sleep trying to guess what's on your mind.
What do you want to do? Play a game of 20 questions?
John, we've had our share of tensions between us. I'm casting them all aside now. If we can just talk together. Like we always should.
A race of robotic machines, Marion. From who knows how many stars away. Already here. Promising to begin the destruction of every living thing on this planet. Us. Tomorrow. We're going to fight. And by God, we're going to win.